What happened to your annulment case with Hillary?
Miranda, I told you about the situation. The court is still reviewing all of the evidence regarding the case. It's not easy. Annulment cases go through a long process.
Can't you do something to speed up the process? How long are you going to make me wait for that? I've sacrificed a lot for you, Salvador. I only ask for one thing. Can you tell me the truth? Are you serious about this, or am I waiting for nothing?
Oh, come on, Miranda. Are you implying that I'm not doing anything, or that I'm intentionally delaying it? You're well aware that it's a tedious process. Give me a break. I don't have the power or influence to rush the annulment, you know?
Don't try to fool me, because if there's a will, there's a way.
In case you haven't noticed, our son Gael just died recently. I'm running for a local government position, and I'm trying to get myself acquitted from all of the pending cases that were filed against me. If I haven't been able to expedite the annulment case, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's not important to me.
Now that Gael is gone, all I want is to secure and fight for the family that I have left.
Miranda, you know that we're family, whether it's legally official or not. Having my last name is not the only way to prove that. I'm never going to leave your side. And after we resolve all of my problems, just tell me which church you'd like to get married in. And we'll get married there. Okay?
What were you thinking, Tantan?
Why are you mad at me, Sam? In fact, they're the ones at fault here, you know?
Well, that's not the point, okay? Can't you just avoid getting yourself into trouble?
And then what? Should I just let them mistreat us? You should have heard all the horrible things that Gavin said about Miss Hillary.
You know what? One of these days, you'll get into trouble because of your bad temper.
If you lecture me all day, you shouldn't have defended me. Because I can defend myself.
What? Well, isn't that what everybody says here, am I right? That they can manage to do it on their own. But they don't even consider the feelings of the people who are worried for them. Tantan, I know that you think I'm the villain here, okay? But I'm just really worried about you.
Is that true? Even after all the things I've done to you in the past?
Well, Anna considers you as her brother. I also have the responsibility to take care of you, as her sister. So I'm going to do it, whether I like it or not. So please don't do this again, okay? Don't get yourself into any fights if it's not necessary. Do you understand me?
Yes, I do. I appreciate it. Thank you for defending me.
Don't mention it.
And one more thing. I really don't see you as a villain, you know? You have a bit of an attitude, but I know you're a good person.
Xander.
It's for you.
This is a lot. What's this for?
It's for your baby. I thought you might need these in the future. It'll surely come in handy when the baby's born.
Oh, Xander, thank you very much for these. If Gael was alive, I'm sure he'd be so thankful for your gifts. By the way, how's the investigation going?
Anna, I'm really sorry. The police hasn't found any suspects until now.
How come? What about Miranda and Salvador?
Well, they're not considering them as suspects. They have a lot of alibi. I'm really sorry. But don't you worry, Anna. I'm sure we'll eventually find evidence against them. We'll do everything we can to achieve justice for Gael.
I appreciate it, Xander. You've already done so much for me. You don't have to apologize at all. You being my friend is more than enough for me. I consider all of you as my family. When I'm with you, I don't feel so alone anymore. Thank you so much. Come on, why don't you stay a while? Let's bring this inside.
It's fine. I just wanted to give you that. I have to go.
Are you sure? Well, okay. All right then. Thank you, and
you're
be
welcome.
Safe. Xander.
Samantha.
You're leaving?
Yes, I am. Well, I just gave something to Anna. I saw a few things for the baby and I decided to buy it for her.
You do know that my sister is still mourning, right?
Samantha. I've already accepted that Anna only sees me as a friend. I'm doing this without expectations.
Well, just so we're clear. But thanks a lot. I'm happy that my sister has a friend she can depend on, Xander. Well, everyone knows my sister's an easy person to love. Because every time she sees someone being taken advantage of, she'll do everything to help them. That's why she's loved by so many people. But I guess we're just too different.
I don't think you and Anna are too different from each other. Both of you are brave. And you'll do everything you can to protect the ones you love the most. It's natural to have some differences. But it doesn't mean that one is better than the other.
Well, if that's true, then why does she always end up luckier than I am?
Tell me, Samantha. What makes you unlucky? You still have your mom and a sister who loves you. A lot of people would wish to have a family like yours. And I am one of them.
Well, maybe you're right.
You know what? As long as you compare yourself to other people, you will never be truly happy. I think you should learn to appreciate and value what you already have. I'll go ahead.
Thank you very much. Let me introduce the new governor of San Ildefonso, Salvador del Mundo.
Congratulations!
Yes!
Governor! I'm so happy! Congratulations! Oh, thank you for all your support!
Governor!
The counting of ballots is still ongoing in San Sebastian, and based on the results of the initial election polls, it seems to be a tight race between Mrs. Hilary del Mundo and incumbent mayor Raquel Punsalan.
Thank you.
Salvador, what are you doing here? Everyone is waiting for you at the conference hall. The mayors of San Ildefonso are already there.
Not all of them are there yet. I'll just join you there later, okay?
Why? Are you waiting for someone in particular?
Oh, Hillary. Mayor. I'm glad that you made it today.
Why wouldn't I make it? I have every right to be here, as a mayor.
This is just a courtesy call, Hillary. You're not required to be here. And you certainly didn't have to bring your companions.
They're not the only ones who came. Tantan and Samantha are on their way here as well. You know how families are, am I right? They always stick together.
What a shame. Too bad they're not allowed inside the hall. Only the immediate family can come inside.
Nobody told us about that.
Well, I'm telling you right now.
Mommy, it's fine. We don't mind waiting outside.
No. You're coming with me, Anna. All of you. Because if we were to follow that strict rule, then you shouldn't be here in the first place. You're not an official family member, right?
Fortunately, everyone already knows who I am in Salvador's life.
Yes. You're a mistress. A frustrated Mrs. Del Mundo.
That's because of you. The desperate ex-wife who refuses to let go of Salvador. Because you know you're nothing. If you didn't carry the prestigious Del Mundo last name, you wouldn't even have won as mayor.
Governor Del Mundo, congratulations to you. What can you say about Mrs. Del Mundo becoming mayor?
Of course I'm very happy, and I'm proud of her. And I know that she learned a lot from me.
Actually, Governor, I haven't learned that much, so I would appreciate it if you could teach me some things. Preferably after work hours, Governor.
Can we have a picture of you together with Mrs. Del Mundo?
What are you doing? That man said Mrs. Del Mundo. That's me.
Miss, excuse me, would you know where the governor will be holding his meeting together with the newly elected officials?
Oh, it's over there, ma'am, at the end of the hallway.
Okay, I'll just go straight?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
I'm not going to allow you to fool me ever again. Just give me back my money.
Come on, Mr. Victorino. You know that's not possible. Because we're the only ones who can supply you with the firearms that you are going to need.
Ma'am, this area is restricted, I'm sorry.
Fine.
Mr. Victorino.
Salvador.
Have a seat.
The news going around was true. You settled for being a governor.
Just governor? That's not true. Please do not belittle my government position. Come on, it's still going to be very beneficial to us. See, as a governor, I'm going to have more freedom to do certain things. And also, this way, there will be less prying eyes who will be getting in the way of our business transactions. Am I right?
I haven't forgotten what your daughter did to me. I almost went to jail because of that woman.
Mm-hmm. I sincerely apologize for the trouble she caused you. But please, why don't we just forget about the past, hmm? We have to move forward. You know, I'm actually planning to get back into business.
How can I be guaranteed that I won't get myself into trouble again?
Oh, I have definitely learned a lot of lessons from the past. And now, I will be more involved when it comes to all of our transactions.
I'm going to keep that in mind, Salvador.
Okay. I will wait for your answer. But then, if you think about it, Mr. Victorino, no one else can supply you with the firearms apart from me. Am I right? By the way...
What's this?
Here. It's for you. Take it. You'll find an address there. Follow the directions and go to that place. My presents are waiting for you. New firearms. It's all yours.
Are you serious?
Of course.
I have to go.
I'll see you.
Thank you. Mom, what if they are busy?
Don't worry about it. We're just visiting. The reason why we're here is we need to show your aunt and uncle they have our full support. But unfortunately, I don't know where their office is. All right, why don't you stay here and I'll ask people around.
Oh, I'm so sorry. So it's you again.
Congratulations. You're candidate one. Your family must be really lucky.
That wasn't luck. The reason why Ma'am Hillary won was because the voter saw her conviction, not like your uncle.
So what are you implying? That my uncle cheated?
Oh, you're the one who said that, not from me.
Next time, you better watch your words, dude. You don't know what's coming for you.
Did you just threaten me?
Why, did I say anything?
Hey! What is this? Huh? What is this, Gavin? What did he do? That's Anna's brother. Why were you talking to him? Did he do anything bad to you?
That guy's been on my case since the campaign started, Uncle.
What?
Don't worry, Uncle. I can handle it.
That's not okay with me. That filthy boy should know who you are. You are my family, okay? He shouldn't treat you that way. What is that?
My mom and I wanted to give it to you, Uncle.
Thank you.
I know exactly what I saw earlier, Anna. That man was a part of Dad's syndicate. And I'm sure if Dad revives his illegal business, everything we've done and all the progress we've made will be for nothing.
I won't let that happen, because we're going to stop him.
How do we do that? We don't have any evidence against him. And he is the governor of San Ildefonso. And because of it, I'm sure that firearms will be shipped in and out of this province without a problem.
We can figure out a way. We'll try to find out where he keeps his supply of firearms. Then we're going to stop his clients. We better do something as soon as possible, while they're just starting out.
You're pregnant, Anna. It'd be better if you just leave this to me now. If Salvador finds out that you're monitoring his every move, I'm sure he won't hesitate to have you killed.
So you just expect me to do nothing here? When Gael was still alive, they already tried to have me killed. What's going to stop him now that Gael's gone?
That's exactly why you should be more cautious, Anna.
I think Xander's right. Just let the two of us handle it.
I want an update on the case immediately, attorney.
Okay, ma'am.
I'll make sure to let you know once the fiscal releases the decision regarding their annulment.
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Attorney?
Yes?
I think my sister's getting impatient. I mean, who wants to be called a partner forever, right? So, please work on it immediately so that my sister's dream wedding will finally come true.
I'll certainly do my best, okay? Excuse me.
Attorney, I have a question. When the two of them are finally married, does that mean that all of their assets become conjugal property? Is that it?
You're right. Well, that's usually the case, ma'am.
Okay? Bye.
Oh, attorney, one last question. Let's say they have no direct heir. Now that Gael is gone, who's going to inherit all of their properties?
Well, it really depends, ma'am. If they don't have a child, the properties may end up in the hands of the spouse, or it can also end up with a parent. Unless they decide to declare someone to inherit all of their assets. All right?
Okay. Thank you, attorney.
You're welcome. I'm happy to help.
I like that idea, huh? Let's prioritize the development of San Ildefonso. Let's tear down the old buildings, so that way we can build new ones for the people. Okay? That's good.
I beg to disagree, Governor. You know very well that our province's revenue is not big. Where are we going to get the budget to fund that infrastructure program?
Mayor Del Mundo, for your information, we have investors who are ready to help us.
Oh, and then what? Are we going to pass on the rest of the expenditures in the people of San Ildefonso? A lot of people here are living in poverty, Governor. So what they really need are proper shelter and food, a secure job, and health care. They don't need a new building.
I agree with Mayor Del Mundo. Majority of the towns in San Ildefonso are underdeveloped. We don't need new buildings in our town, Governor.
Well, it's all right with me. I mean, your idea sounds nice. We are free to express our opinions over here. But as for me, Mayor Del Mundo, I just need to know more of your insights on this. Go ahead now, huh? Do you have any suggestions? So that way, people here wouldn't think that you're doing this to spite me.
Samantha, you didn't have to accompany me here, you know?
After what happened to Anna? I can't just do nothing about it, Xander. Especially now that Dad was elected as governor. I'm scared and worried of what he could do to our family. Even more so now, after we find out that Dad might be resuming operations of his illegal business.
All right. But the reason why we're here, Sam, is to protect Hillary. And to find evidence that we could use against Salvador.
I'm going to text you the address. The weapons should be there. But bring some of our men with you. It's better to be sure. Yes.
I have a suggestion.
Okay.
Why don't we start with livelihood projects? Because most of the people from San Ildefonso rely mostly on industrial work, as well as factories, and some of them work in mines. Why don't we teach the people how to run a business?
How can those people run their own businesses if they don't have the money?
Why don't we lend these people money for their capital? In that way, not only can they start their own business, they can also create more opportunities for other people. Empowering our people can also lead to San Ildefonso's development as well.
I have to go now. I'll just give you a call later.
Hillary? I was wrong about you. You were good at convincing the people with your ideas. Imagine if we both ran in the elections before. I'm sure we could have achieved more together.
Well, if I did that, and I became your running mate, I bet our marriage would have ended much sooner, Salvador.
That's what I like about you. That's why I fell in love with you, because you can really speak your mind. Even though you're at a disadvantage.
All my life, Salvador, I had to do my very best so I could prove myself to both my parents. You of all people should know that. That's why I'm a strong woman, independent, and knows what she wants. Do you know what I learned from all of my experiences in life? That is to never let anyone treat me poorly or take advantage of me ever again, not even my own husband.
Husband? No matter what you tell me, I'm happy that you still refer to me as your husband. Hillary, we don't have to let it get to this point.
After everything that happened, do you honestly think I'd want to be with you again? You completely ruined my life, Salvador, and you hurt my daughter, Samantha. I don't care about you anymore. The only reason why I'm talking to you is because of my job now.
I'm going to win you back, Hillary. Because I always get what I want.
Hey, Samantha.
What? We need to go after that guy.
He got suspicious. It's too risky to follow him now. But don't worry about it. We'll get another chance. We need to be careful, Samantha.
I can't believe this. Our suspicions were right all along. Dad is going to run his old business again.
I understand how you feel. Now that San Ildefonso is under his rule, he became more powerful because of it. Remember, we have to be more vigilant.
It's a good thing we didn't get caught earlier. Thank you.
Samantha, if you really want to help Ana and I on this mission, and finally bring Salvador down, there's still so much you have to learn.
That's weird. I remember you and Yvonne telling me about you guys not being able to trust me because you think I'm weak.
But you've already done so much to prove to all of us that you're trustworthy, Samantha. I do. I trust that you can help us achieve justice. Anyway, let's go. Ana needs to know about this. Come on.
Gavin?
Yes, Aunt?
This is for you.
What is this for?
Just read it. I know you're a smart kid, Gavin, so I think that you should use your time wisely. We're going to help you, so you can reach your dream of becoming a lawyer.
I don't think I can accept this.
Why can't you accept it? You're my nephew. I want you to have a bright future ahead of you, and I'm sure that your mom wants that as well.
Thanks a lot, Aunt. I'm not going to waste this opportunity. I promise you that when I get a job...
Oh, come on now. It's not a loan that you need to pay back, okay? It's our gift to you.
Natasha!
Oh, my goodness!
What are you doing? Did you drop something there?
Were you there the whole time?
Yes, Miranda.
Mom, is it all right to accept my aunt's offer?
Most definitely, son. Miranda, I just want to thank you for everything. Because you're always here to support me. I don't know how I'm going to repay you for all the help you gave me.
Don't worry about it. Gavin is also my responsibility. Excuse me.
Besides, we've got nothing to worry about, Gavin. I know you're smart, huh? You'll be a good lawyer someday like Gael, right? Just do well in your studies and no distractions.
I will, Uncle.
Speaking of distractions, huh? Do you remember that rascal you had a fight with? Don't worry about him. I've already taken care of him,
Hey, that's our target.
Hey, kid,
Hold on.
What's the matter, sir?
It's already past curfew. Why are you still out?
That's a violation. You have to come with us, Kent.
Hold on. My house is right there. Why are you arresting
me?
I'm
not a minor, sir. Wait. Stop asking questions.
Sir,
hey,
come on.
Are you even
police officers?
Let's go.
Why aren't you in uniform?
Let's go.
Help
come
me.
On, boy. Somebody.
Just come with
help.
Us.
Help. Help me. Shut up. Please help. Come on. Let's go. Help me.
Dan? Dan? Dan, get over here. Hurry. Help us! Somebody help us!
Help us! Somebody help us!
Let's go.
Are you all right?
Yes, Anna.
Come on, let's go inside now.
Yes, I know. Don't worry about it, okay? I'll have my men investigate it right away. Okay. You heard that?
Yes, sir.
Go to where Victorino is, okay? You have to find out who's been following him around. I'm pretty sure that Anna has something to do about it.
Got it, Governor.
Go on. What is it?
Governor, we're so sorry.
Why?
We couldn't abduct Anna's brother.
What? What happened? How did he get away?
Anna suddenly came, and she saved her brother.
And so? Get back over there, keep an eye on Anna, and give me an update every hour, okay?
Yes, boss.
Yes, boss.
You shouldn't have done that, Anna. You're pregnant. What if something bad happened to your baby?
I'm all right.
Anna.
That's enough.
I want you safe, Anna. Don't worry about me.
Mommy.
What's going on?
It's Dan Dan. He almost got abducted by men pretending to be policemen.
What? Are you all right?
Yes, ma'am. It's a good thing Anna went outside. If she hadn't, something bad
Dan,
might have happened to me.
That's enough. Stop worrying. What matters is that you're safe now.
Look, let me handle it. I'll call the chief of police now, so he can investigate the incident.
Don't bother, Mommy. We already know that Salvador is behind all of this. Especially that he's a governor now. He already warned me before. I know he wants revenge.
Anna, maybe it's better if you move out of this place. I'm pretty sure that Salvador won't leave you guys alone as long as he's the governor.
Please don't say that, Emmy. Mama's already been elected as mayor here. So she can take care of us. She can protect us.
Well,
Right, Mom?
Yeah, of course. I can request for security. But then, Samantha, I think Emmy has a point. You need to get out of this place soon, most especially you.
Mommy.
Anna, I know that you're worried about the safety of your family, most especially for your baby, and I understand that.
But what about you?
Don't worry about me. I'll be fine here. What's important is that you all remain safe.
Miranda, why are you crying?
I just miss my son. Gael was such a cute kid back then. You know what? He looks like Gavin when he was still a little boy.
You think so?
Too bad I don't have any of Gavin's baby pictures with me.
That's all right. But I did notice the resemblance.
See? I told you. We're a family of beautiful people. Miranda, I know that you're going through a rough time right now. I can't even begin to imagine how I'm going to feel if that were to happen to my son, Gavin. But I want you to know that you're not alone. We're here for you. Gavin and I will always be here to support you. We're going to be here until the day you finally feel okay. So don't be sad anymore. Miranda, have I ever told you that
You don't look good when you cry. Just kidding. Come on, Miranda, you're way too serious right now. How about this? So you would feel better, why don't we visit Gael's grave tomorrow? Do you want that? Is that okay with you? You know, so that the two of us can have some time together. I was also thinking we could go to the mall after, do some shopping, as long as you're paying.
I'll just go to bed now.
Miranda, so are we on for tomorrow?
7 o'clock, sharp. You should be prepared by then.
Yes, ma'am. Miranda, sweet dreams.
Good night. Gael, you probably know the reason why we visited you today. Looks like it's going to take some time before we can visit your grave again. I hope you understand, Gael. I just want to say sorry to you. This is the only way I can think of to make sure that our child is safe. We are going to leave the house tonight. To be honest, I still don't know where we're going. But I hope you understand my reasons. Don't you worry about us. Because I know that no matter where we go, I'll always carry you in my heart. I'll tell our child stories about you every single day. I will remind our child every day so our child will always remember how much Gael loves him.
It's okay, Anna. Just let it out.
Are you done? Can I have my turn?
You know what, Miranda? Whether you like it or not, I'm Gael's wife. And I have the right to mourn for him, too.
Well, I am Gael's mother. From the moment I bore my own son, I already gave my life to Gael. I sacrificed so much for him, to give him a bright future. But all of that went to waste when you came into his life. And it's all because of his stupid love for you!
Oh my gosh! Anna! Anna! Are you okay? Are you okay? Does it hurt?
I'm fine. Huh? Why so dramatic? You just fell down. You're not gonna die from that, you know.
Hey! You shut up!
Oh, I'm so scared!
Ignore her.
No! She doesn't have the right to treat us this way. Now I know why Gael never mentioned anything about you before. Because you're a selfish and inconsiderate woman. Wow, what kind of thinking is that? You already stole my sister's precious time to be with her son. And now you want us to be considerate to you? Excuse me.
Didn't I say that you should shut your mouth up? You talk a lot for someone who doesn't know anything.
Ignore them. Let's go.
What's wrong?
What?
My stomach hurts. It hurts.
What?
Anna?
Anna!
Take me to the hospital. I can't take it.
Here. Excuse me. Mister. Take us to the nearest hospital, please, now.
Faster, Natasha. Emin, let's go. Hello? All right, then. I'm on my way there. Natasha, I want you to follow them.
Me? Why me?
There's an important meeting in the office. I have to be there.
Miranda,
hurry!
I don't want to commute. Miranda! Oh, excuse me. Mr. Tricycle, excuse me! Wait up! Please, wait up!
Hello, sir. Anna was here at the cemetery earlier. She was with Mom Samantha.
The rest of the family's at home right now.
Don't let Anna get away, all right? And you'd better be sure to keep a close watch on everybody, because we're going to carry out the plan tonight.
Are we going to get rid of their whole family as well?
All of them. So no one can talk. Make sure to clean up all the evidence. Make it look as if they all vanished into thin air. Leave no trace.
How's my baby doing, Doctor?
We've already checked your baby's condition, Mrs. Del Mundo. You have nothing to worry about. Your child is safe.
That's great. Thank you, Doctor.
Just wait for me here. I'll just get the ultrasound results, ma'am. Okay?
Yes, Doctor.
I'll be right back. Excuse me.
We can't allow this to happen again, okay?
What do you mean?
You can't get close to Miranda.
Don't worry about me. We're going to leave soon. We won't encounter Miranda again.
Miss? Excuse me, where can I inquire if I'm looking for a certain patient?
At the information desk, ma'am. It's located at the ground floor.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Why aren't they home yet?
Oh, I called them. They're on their way home. They just stopped by the hospital.
Why? What happened?
They didn't say, Ma'am Hillary. But I'm pretty sure it's just a routine checkup.
Tantan, when you arrive at your destination later, please make sure to take care of the sisters. Just let me know if there's any problem, all right?
Ma'am Hillary, where are we going anyway?
You're going to my friend's place for now. She has a rest house in a private island. I'm sure Salvador will never find you if you stay there.
We really appreciate all the help you've given us, Ma'am Hillary.
Please promise me that you'll be careful.
Yes, we will.
Are your things ready, guys? Because we can leave any minute now.
All right.
Pregnant with Gael's child? Oh, attorney, one last question. Let's say they have no direct heir. Now that Gael is gone, who's going to inherit all of their properties?
Well, it really depends, ma'am. If they don't have a child, the properties may end up in the hands of the spouse, or it can also end up with a parent. Unless they decide to declare someone to inherit all of their assets.
My son, Gavin, should inherit everything.
Natasha.
Miranda.
So what happened? Did you follow both of them? Where did they go?
Well, I followed them, but I just saw the two of them go inside a restaurant. Miranda, why did you have them followed anyway?
You don't need to know, Natasha.
Well, in that case, you don't need to know their secret as well, Miranda. If they want to keep it from you, that's a huge advantage for me.